So you have received an Internet Assisted Review IAR invitation. This video tutorial guides your viewers on how to get started in IAR upon receiving the Scientific Review invitation emails from the Scientific Review Officer, SRO. Please note that the process for responding to an invitation to review is the same for both domestic and international reviewers. A Scientific Review Officer, SRO, or an Extramural Support Assistant, ESA, gives a reviewer access to IAR on a per-meeting basis. This process is called enabling. Once enabled for a meeting, you receive an email invitation. The email varies depending on whether the reviewer is new to Commons, has a PI role in Commons, or already has the IAR role. This tutorial focuses on users who are new to ERA Commons, since the process is simpler for the other scenarios. Create a Commons account. For those new to Commons, you will receive a system-generated email from ERA Notify at mail.nih.gov with an SRO's signature. The email includes directions on how to create a Commons account for IAR and a unique link for accessing ERA Commons to begin creating a new account. You must not share this URL with others, as it may lead to login problems in the future. Clicking the unique link in the email brings you to one step of a two-step process to create a new account. As a new reviewer, you enter information for the required fields as marked with the red asterisks. When done, click Save and Continue to move to the next page. If you are not new to ERA Commons, Step 2 verifies any previous NIH grant support and committee service in which you have participated. Look over the list of previous applications for which you participated as the principal investigator to ensure the information is accurate. Also, review any previous or active committee involvement information and confirm if it is correct. If you have never participated in the review process before, this section will be blank, or it may have the information for the review committee you are invited to participate in. You can also add a comment for NIH or reject the request to create an account. If you move forward in the process to create an account, click the Complete Account Request button. You'll see a confirmation message when you've completed the process. A second email will be sent to confirm the account creation request. It may take a few days for the account to be reviewed and activated by NIH staff. A third email confirms that the account has been activated and includes your username. It is followed by a fourth email with a temporary password. Please click the Commons URL in this email and log into ERA Commons using the username and password provided in the emails. The system will immediately prompt you to change your password from the temporary one provided in the email to one of your choosing. Be sure to remember the new password you created. You'll need it to link your Commons account to your Login.gov account. Fill out your personal profile. First, verify that your username and the new password are working by logging into Commons. From the landing page, click on the Personal Profile button and make sure that you have entered all the required fields on the ERA Commons personal profile. Make sure that you have entered an email address to receive reviewers' correspondence. Note that you must complete all the required fields for the following sections: Name and ID, Demographics, Employment, and Reviewer Information. If you fail to complete all the required fields and you try to navigate away from the screen, all the changes you have made to that point will be lost. You see a warning message if all the fields are not completed when you attempt to save the profile. Associate your Commons account with login.gov. Next, and before you can access the Internet Assisted Review screen, you'll need to create a login.gov account from the ERA Commons home screen and associate it with your ERA Commons account. Using login.dev credentials adds a second layer of security as part of the two-factor authentication process, which is required to access IAR. If you need to create a login.gov account, click on the login.gov logo on the ERA Commons login screen. On the login.gov screen, click Create an Account and then follow the prompts. Once the account is created, then you associate your new login.gov account with your ERA Commons account. On the Associate Your ERA Commons Account screen, enter your ERA Commons username and password and click Continue to complete the association. Do not enter your login.gov credentials. This association is a one-time process. With the login.gov account now associated with your ERA Commons account, you go to the ERA Commons home screen and click the login.gov logo. Enter your login.gov credentials and complete the two-factor authentication process. Once logged in, click the Internet Assisted Review IAR button. Before you are able to access the applications assigned to you by the SRO, you must do two things. First, you must sign the confidentiality statement electronically, one time for each meeting, regardless of the meeting phase. If you have not signed the statement for the meeting, the only available action is the confidentiality statement link, which is accessed by clicking the three-dot ellipsis icon in the meeting column on the list of meetings screen. This link is removed once the statement is signed. Complete required reviewer training. With the confidentiality statement signed, the IAR list of meetings screen is displayed. However, the second thing you must do before you're able to access your list of applications for the submit phase is complete the required reviewer training courses. The training is required once every 3 years. If you have not completed the required courses, you will see a message on the list of meetings screen with a link to the courses. It is important to note that the training courses are not required for the recruitment phase. This means you can access the list of meetings screen, sign the confidentiality agreement, and determine and disclose any conflicts of interest, COI. Now, back to the submit phase. Clicking the link takes you to the reviewer training site. Click the Go to login.gov blue button, then click the login.gov logo on the next screen. Enter the same login.gov credentials that you used to log into ERA Commons and follow the prompts. Once the authentication process is finished, you are presented with the training options. Each course takes approximately 30 minutes to complete. Once the modules are completed, your status is automatically and immediately updated, and you will have access to your signed applications. Now on the list of meetings screen, when you click on the three-dot ellipsis icon, you see a variety of different links, such as View List of Applications, Pre-Meeting COI Certification, Meeting Materials, and View Access Code for Downloads, and related items. Note that you see different links depending on which phase the meeting is in. Resources. There are a number of additional resources that are available to you for IAR if you need them. If you are having technical issues with IAR, please contact the ERA Service Desk. This concludes this video tutorial on how to get started in IAR upon receiving the Scientific Review Invitation emails from a Scientific Review Officer, SRO. We very much appreciate your service as a reviewer. Thank you for watching.